Hey fellow animators, I'm Miloš Černý. So, you have done a walk cycle animation for your game, and you of course have a basic idle stand pose as well. But most characters will need some transition animations between these two activities for it to look good. So, let's take a look at how to do a stop walk transition animation for our favorite wolf here. Okay, so we have two animations here in the stack. One is procedural walk with three adjustment layers, and one is a stand pose, which is just a pose with a stand, surprisingly. It doesn't have any animation. So we want to blend these two animations together and create a transition game animation, walk to stand. First I'm going to collapse this walk animation with all the adjustment layers into one absolute layer. So I have to change few things first. Let's start by switching the procedural walk to move in space. And also change the timeline range to have some frames even below zero. And add few to the end, just to have the animation a bit longer. You can see I have used multiplications of 32 because my walk is 32 frames long, but it's not that important actually. I would like to specifically give shout out to my Patreons today. Thank you to all of you again, because you are the ones that make these videos possible. I struggle to find motivation to make more videos, but you guys keep me going. If any of you my viewers find these videos helpful, support on Patreon is the best way possible to get more of them. Thank you again. Okay, collapse the layer to have keys on each frame for every bone. And let's rename it to Walk 32F again. Now I have turned the layer off and switched back the procedural animation to be on place again. Because I need to figure out which frame of the walk I'm going to use as an exit frame. The frame where I will start the transition. I have activated layer transform gizmo for the disabled stand pose layer, just so I can see it as well. It's the yellow outlines of the bones. Here I am looking at what frame are the legs in the most suitable position. Basically all the legs should go through at least one cycle movement, meaning going up and down once. So we have enough time to reduce the speed from walking to stand. I have decided for the frame 10. Because it's quite similar to the stand pose, and that means I will do one full cycle during the transition. Now when that is decided, I want to move this frame to 0. It's not exactly necessary, but I like my animations to start at frame 0 if possible. I have to move all the keys to the left by 10 frames, so let's add those to the timeline. Hit this button here to move the layers. And move the last one by 10 frames to the left. It's the same as if you would select all the keys for all the bones and move them on the timeline, but this is just faster. Okay, now our frame 10 is at frame 0, but the animation is also moved to the left a bit. We could move it by hand like I do here. But if you want to be precise, and for the game animations you should be, you could do it like this. Find the frame 10 in the original procedural layer. Create new absolute layer, which will basically create a layer with that frame as a pose without any animation. Now let's compare our frame at 0 to this frame. And we can see it's a little bit off. So let's just move it so it matches the original. This is precise enough to not see any difference, so it's okay. Now let's start with editing the walk layer. First we need to take care of pelvis, because that affects everything. And especially the Y position axis is important for us. We don't need keys beyond 0, so let's delete this. Now we have to decide how many frames do we need for the animation. I'm going with 40 because that should be okay, but it depends on the character, the speed of the walk animation and so on. But let's say 40. So I have made a key for y-axis at frame 40. I want the pelvis to gradually slow down as the time goes by, which means it has to have a curve like this. If we play the animation now, you can see the pelvis slows down. The rest of the things are still moving, but focus on the pelvis. By this, we have also confirmed that 40 frames should be okay for the animation, because it looks fine at the moment. Now, because we are going to blend this walk layer together with the stand layer, we have to animate some movement for the stand layer as well. Basically, you want to match it as close as possible with the purple walk layer. Something like this, but we also have to change the curve to be similar to the walk one. Now they move more or less together. Okay, let's do the actual blending. For the pelvis at frame 40, set local weight value to 0. This means that the pelvis will lose weight on walk layer from frame 0 to 40. The key on 0 is created automatically. And because the next layer underneath this one is the yellow stand pose, it will start playing animation gradually from that one. Do the same for the chest, head and tail. 100% on frame 0 and 0% on frame 40. If you play the animation now, you can see that everything gradually stops and only the legs keep moving forward. Now we have to deal with the legs and we will do that in the next video. I am Miloš Černý and thank you for watching.